This is our third fencing little demonstration video. Hi everybody, I'm Barry Eschenbrenner. I am the Senior Farm Manager here at the Horticulture Agroforestry Research Center, New Franklin, Missouri. This is our third fencing little demonstration video. I'm gonna show you another style of fence. Now these were put in before I got here. So this is gonna go back 7-8 years now from right now. Not that that really matters, but that's just the way it is. This fence, as we showed you the other one with the hog panel, where the hog panel was down here, this is what I call woven wire or page wire type fence. It's cheaper than the hog panel, and you buy this in a roll and you stretch it out. On this particular fence, wooden posts were used along with T-post, and as you can see, they went with the tall T-posts, which were, I'm presuming, were about 9 footers, 10 footers perhaps, and then a normal size T-post. And this fence can be, we don't use it anymore because the trees are so large, we don't have to really worry about deer. This could be electrified. Unlike the other fences that I've showed you in the previous videos, those were poly wire. This is not poly wire. This is just what we call old style electric fence wire. It's the nice thing about it, it's really tough. It lasts forever, galvanized. Bad thing about it, it's not as easy to work with. So if you ever decide you're gonna take it down, it doesn't roll up real easily. It's kind of a chore, unlike the poly wire, but it works just as effectively. It's a little tougher to pull tight. You can't pull this wire tight and wrap it around your insulators like the poly wire. That allows you to make that fence look tighter. It doesn't make it any better. It's just totally a cosmetic thing to make it look nicer. This is a lot like the other fence I showed you with the hog panels, in the sense that if you lose power, it's not the end of the world. Or if you don't want to use power, it's okay, because you've got this right here. You've got this page wire that's going to keep deer out. It's not going to do much for your smaller animals because they'll just crawl right through it. But it's a fairly cheap fence to build. Some of the drawbacks I see to it is that this one here has been sprayed with glyphosate, so it's pretty much weedless. But you know, you do see new trees coming on, and you're always going to have to be fighting, just like you would on any type of fence. You're always going to have some brush issues and things like that to contend with. So there's some maintenance in it. Lasts a long time. Probably a very, and it would work. It does work. Down, you can't see where we are here, but down below we have elderberries, and we had some issues trying to keep deer out, and this fence does seem to work, especially if you will electrify the top. Thanks for watching this one.
Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure that you like, share, and subscribe to our channel, Mizzou Agroforestry.